We're here at Sandy Point today to teach you how to anchor well. The easiest way to do that is to understand how an anchor works. So I've got a Danforth-style anchor here, and we're gonna show you on the beach what is actually happening underwater when you anchor from your boat. Before I get started showing you how the anchor works, just a couple of quick terms. The line that's attached to the anchor is referred to as a road. So when you hear me say payout road, what I mean is setting the line out so that it drapes across the bottom so the anchor can set. There's also a little bit of chain in this road. We'll talk about that later. This is a Danforth style anchor. It has these big flukes. This is really good for sand, which is why we chose it for this demonstration today. Now, the other thing you're gonna hear me talk about is scope. Scope's a little nebulous, but it's a ratio. The deeper the water is, the more line you have to pay out to make your anchor set. This demonstration will show you exactly why. Scope is measured as bow to bottom. So water depth plus the distance from the water to the bow, that is the distance you need to keep in mind for the ratio. So if you've got 6 feet of water that you're trying to anchor in, you got 3 feet to the bow, your magic number is 9. And the ratio you need to keep in mind is 5 to 1. That is the minimum. You need at least 5 to 1 to make the anchor have a best chance of setting and staying correctly. So the reason scope is so important is to make sure that the angle at which you're pulling the anchor across the bottom is very low. The long line lets it be very horizontal, lets this anchor start to bite. You see how it's digging in there? That's what's gonna keep this anchor in the bottom. If your scope is too little, if the line's too short, you're gonna be pointed up towards the bow, and you'll notice the flukes are now just kind of sipping across the sand there. They can't bite. This is now no better than a paperweight. Pretend for a moment I'm on the bow of the boat. Now, I'm gonna lower this anchor in, lower it, don't throw it, and it's gonna fall more or less vertically to the bottom. Now, as the boat drifts backwards, it should tip towards the bow of the boat. And your job up on the bow is to pay the road out approximately the same speed as the boat drifts backwards. You don't want to just throw it all on top because you could foul the anchor and prevent it from setting. All right, so we're back on the bow. We've lowered our anchor in and we're slowly paying out that road about the same speed as the boat drifts back. And when we get to the necessary amount of line for our water depth, we're gonna snub it off. So it means we're gonna take a wrap or so around the cleat or post that we use to anchor, and we're gonna start to put a little pressure on that line. Now you can let that line slip through that cleat just a little bit to help that anchor bite rather than giving it a sharp jerk, because it'll give it a better chance of digging in. When it's got a good bite, then you can snub it off completely, tie down that hitch, and you'll be done anchoring. So now you're worried about getting enough line out. You wanna make sure that you have that scope correct. You don't have to do a lot of math. I'll make it easy for you. Remember we said we were in 6 feet of water, 3 more to the bow, the magic number was 9. 5 times 9 is 45. Don't do the math, do arm's lengths. Lower that over the side till it hits the bottom, and then just start measuring the width of your arms. Most of us are between 5 and 6 feet tall. Guess what? If you do this 9 times, you're gonna have that magic ratio. Just keep counting as you go back till you get to 9 and then snub it off, you're all set. And if you lowered it to the bottom at the beginning, you're actually at 6 to 1 already. So the other thing you can do to help make your anchoring easier is to add a short length of chain to the end of your road. Now this is my lunch setup essentially for my 20-foot boat. This is a real simple lightweight anchor, but even this little bit of chain helps keep that line down and helps this anchor set quickly. For other situations, for rocky or bad bottoms, there's a lot of folks who will tell you to add much more chain than this. But if you get into an all chain road, you have to have a snubbing line at the bow, there's a whole different setup, it's a whole different video. But for small boats, light wind conditions, not gonna stay very long, this will serve you very well. All right, we've been here for lunch. This anchor is set. I mean, it's really set. How are we gonna get it out? Well, we're not gonna muscle it out. We're gonna use what we just learned about scope. We're gonna reverse the process. So we're gonna gently drive on the anchor, pulling the line up to the bow, and you notice we're getting more and more vertical. And when we get to the vertical point, this anchor should just trip and fall back the other direction, And now we're free to pick it up, clean it off, and stow it for next time. All right, so in the case, if it won't come loose on you, so if it's really dug in somehow, and you drive up on it and simply lifting it won't get it free, snub it off, and then have a crew member bump the boat in and out of forward gear and use the boat's weight to trip it. And if it still won't come loose, you've got a fouled anchor, and that's another video. Hopefully this little demo has given you a better understanding of the basics of how an anchor works. For more great videos, check us out at BoatUS.com or hit that subscribe button. Thanks for watching.